Филадельфия резидент Клайд Александер Шелтон из Ганг оттакет бай Роберс Руперт Эймес энд Кларенс Дарби. Уилл Эймес стилес ол зе джевелри, Дарби стапс Шелтон энд килес хис уайф энд янг датер. Сун зе криминалес а ин зе хандес оф джастис. Бат ассистент дистрикт атторни Ник Рис, ху из лидинг зе кас, информес Шелтон зе тер ис то а литл эвиденс агейнст Эймес энд Дарби ту би сер зе дзе криминалес уилл би конвиктет, энд терифор хэ мейк а садил виз Дарби зе хэ уилл тистифи агейнст Эймес, энд хэ уилл джет а шортер синтенес. Шелтон протестес агейнст зис десишн, бат Ник дос нот пэй аттеншн ту ай ти. As a result, Эймес, the thief who did not stop the killer, is sentenced to death, and Дарби, the killer himself, is sentenced to only 3 years. At the exit of the courthouse, a satisfied Дарби shakes hands with Ник, this scene is watched from afar by a depressed Шелтон. 10 years pass. During the execution of Эймес by lethal injection at the time of the introduction of poisonous to him, Эймес suddenly begins to suffer and instead of a painless death, he dies in terrible agony. Ник Рис discovers the inscription «You can't escape fat» on a poison drip and remembers that Дарби uttered this phrase during a court hearing. The cops are going after Дарби. Mian Hael, an anonymous caller calls the latter, who informs him about the police and orders him to run away. He also tells him that there is a police car near the house with a driver standing by him inside. After escaping from the police, Дарби jets to the car, wakes up the driver and orders him to leave. Arriving at some vacant lot, the policeman takes off his wig, it turns out to be Clyde Shelton. Дарби wants to shoot him with a pistol picked up in the car, but instead of shooting him, needles popped out of the pistol grip stick into his arm. Шелтон explains to Дарби that it is a tetrodotoxin poison extracted from a fish of the Caribbean blowfish species. This poison paralyzes, but it does not relieve pain. Next, Шелтон brings the paralyzed Дарби to an empty warehouse, after which he cuts him into pieces, while filming everything on camera, and sends the recording to Ник Хом. Mian Hael, Ник, having found Дарби, quickly realizes that Шелтон is involved in the murder of Эймес and Дарби. Soon Шелтон is arrested. During the interrogation, Шелтон immediately gives Ник a frank confession. Satisfied, Ник is about to leave, but Шелтон suddenly stops him and puts him down. Noting that there is no evidence against him, seen as in his confession he did not say that he killed Эймес and Дарби, but only said that he only planned the murder and did not specify which one. The video he sent to Ник shows a masked killer. Шелтон hints that Ник is behaving as negligently as the police officers who were looking for evidence against Эймес and Дарби. After a brief verbal struggle, Ник is forced to admit it. Then Шелтон puts forward a condition, he will drive a real confession, and in exchange Ник will bring him a comfortable mattress to the prison cell. Ник, unjarred by Шелтон's bullying, under pressure from his colleague, Jonas Contrelli is forced to agree. However, at the trial, Шелтон not only does not drive confessions, but also successfully rejects all the charges against him and presently deserves him to be released on bail. But when the judge, believing his words, is ready to let him go, Шелтон suddenly breaks down and readily accuses the judge that she immediately believed his false statements and almost let him go, even though he killed two people and almost directly admitted it in the courtroom. Шелтон believes that because of people like her, problems arise in justice. As a result, an angry judge denies him bail, Шелтон returns to prison. Тер, keeping his promise, he formally correctly confesses to the murder of Дарби and Эймес. However, then Шелтон again offers Ник a deal if he delivers him lunch from a good restaurant and turns on the music in the cell at exactly 1 o'clock in the afternoon, the killer will tell him the location of Дарби's lawyer, Bill Reynolds, who disappeared 3 days ago. Ник and his assistants fulfill the condition, but they are 8 minutes late. Шелтон reports the coordinates on Uri. Arriving at the specific place by helicopter, Ник discovers that Reynolds in a hiding place covered with earth with an oxygen cylinder tap in his mouth. Oxygen stopped coming at exactly 13 часов 15 минут, and they got from the prison to Reynolds for 15 minutes, from which Ник concludes that if they had fulfilled Clyde's condition at exactly 13 часов, the lawyer would have survived. At this time, in the cell, Шелтон kills his cellmate with a sharp bone from lunch. Шелтон is put in the punishment cell, where he blames Nick, who visited him, for Reynolds does due to an untimely lunch delivered to him and tells him that he should be responsible for non-compliance with the contract. 13. Jonas introduces Nick to a spy who worked with Clyde for the government, and he informs the Prescottors that Clyde Shelton is a virtuous master of liquidations, who has been using his brilliant intellect for the past 10 years to accurately kill at any distance, adjusting the right events, and know all of the prison cell are an obstacle for him. The spy also says that Clyde is completely invincible, and that if someone injured him, then this someone is dead, and that Parting recommends forgetting this meeting and shooting Clyde in the cell. Nick, realizing that Shelton is much more than heroes than they thought, along with Jonas, asks a federal judge to put Shelton in complete isolation. The judge agrees, and at that moment her phone rings, but as soon as she answers the call and puts the receiver to her ear, deliberately and brazenly violating the rules of behavior in the courthouse, which she demanded from everyone without question, the device embedded in the phone is triggered, causing the judge to die. Nick tries to convince Shelton that his revenge will lead to nothing, but Shelton himself calls his murders not revenge, but a war against a corrupted reality and a corrupt justice system. He sets Nick one more condition, either he will be released by 6 часов, or he will start killing. Nick refuses him, as a result, Shelton blows up all the cars of police officers, 6 people are killed, and Nick's assistant, Sarah Lowell, whom Nick greatly appreciated, is among the dead. In the police office, Nick's assistant is Finta, Buck connected to a bomb detonator. At a meeting with Shelton, Nick beats him up and demands that he stop everything, but Shelton makes it clear to him that the murders will continue. After Sarah's funeral, Nick and Jonas leave the cemetery under the cover of bodyguards. But suddenly all the cars from the column stall out, and Nick notices a remote-controlled shooting robot nearby, which immediately opens fire on the car in which Jonas was, and then blows it up. Nick asks the mayor to resign, but the mayor not only does not accept his resignation, but also appoints the new district attorney instead of Jonas. With the help of Sarah's friend Chester, Nick discovers all of Shelton's property, including an abandoned garage, literally next to the prison. Together with his colleague Donegan, Nick penetrates the store and discovers a tunnel dug by Shelton, leading directly under the prison. In the tunnel, they find a lot of various closets, plans of all city buildings and even monitors that receive a signal from video cameras in the prison. They also discover that Shelton has dug tunnels into all the prison cells, including his punishment cell, but when they go up there, they do not find Clyde. Pretty soon, after examining the documents collected by Clyde, Prescottors realize that Shelton intends to blow up the mayor's office along with everyone who is currently at an emergency meeting in connection with Shelton's activities. Nick and Donegan go there. Mian Hael, Shelton, disguised as a janitor, enters the city hall and sets up a bomb there, after which he goes back. Arriving Nick and Donegan, along with the bomb squad, find a bomb that is activated by a call from a mobile phone. Mian Hael, Shelton returns to the punishment cell, where Nick is already waiting for him. Nick tries to persuade Shelton not to activate the bomb, saying that there are a lot of innocent people in the building, such as Clyde Alexander Shelton and his family 10 years ago, and he has to live with it for the rest of his life. Nick IDDS that he has learned the lesson that Clyde tried to teach him to serve justice with all his might and not make deals with criminals. Shelton thanks Nick and sets the bomb off anyway. Nick leaves the punishment cell, before telling Shelton that he has no more than half a minute left to life, after which he locks the door of the punishment cell. At the same time, Donegan locks the door leading from the punishment cell into the tunnel. Discouraged, Shelton finds a bomb under his bed. There is an explosion. Shelton holds in his hand a bracelet made by his daughter. The letters on the bed set up to the word daddy. The film ends with Nick attending a school concert where his daughter is performing.